Welcome to Vits-ing the Movies. I'm your host, Vits.
And I'm John Carl Barth from Crazy Stupid Media.
The Ladies' Man, starring Tim Meadows as the Ladies' Man. The title of this review will be Get Out of Here, Viewer. You don't want no part of this shit.
Wait, that's the movie we're gonna review?
What's wrong? You always review movies from this century. It's your trademark. And this one came out right at the beginning of it.
Well, it's not that. It's just that, well, this is an SNL movie, and those usually tend to suck.
Aha! That's the key word.
What, suck?
No.
No, I think it is. That seems to be the common denominator here.
No, the key word is usually. Some of the movies in the Saturday Night Live movie franchise, if you can even call it that, have been critical and or financial successes. Since there's a precedent, it's fair to give each new one a chance.
Well, when you put it that way, sure, why not?
Great! Let's begin!
Bourbon. Listen,
I was wondering, can I ask you a question?
I predict that in typical Hollywood comedy fashion, he will say a pickup line and she will laugh despite being an emotional mess.
Was your father a meat burglar? Here's why I asked, because it looked like somebody stole two fine hams and shoved them down the back of your dress.
And then it happened. She started laughing. Leon didn't go home with her, but he took home her business card. She said she was in radio, said she wanted to put Leon on the radio.
Wow, guess you were right.
No, I wasn't.
What are you talking about? She laughed.
Yeah, but I thought that he was gonna say a pickup line that would work in real life in a different situation. You know, with a woman who's not upset. But who in their right mind would not slap this guy after hearing shit like that?
Leon thinks she's gonna be a tough shoe to polish.
Au contraire, bonjour. Let me give you the play-by-play. I would probably begin with a very classy first line. Something like, "Hey, sweet thing, can I buy you a fish sandwich?" And then I will commence to whisper sweet words in her ear. Something like, "Man, I like to take a bite out of your butt." And then I will close the deal by giving her a preview of the good.
Now, the day you pick up that pretty woman, that's the day I believe a wet bird don't fly at night.
Yeah, well, get ready to see a wet bird fly at night, my friend.
Can she really not hear them? They're not that far away.
It is 2:30 in the a.m. and you are listening to the Ladies' Man. Hey, all right, Thola, let's take some more calls. Go ahead, caller.
Hello? Am I on? My wife of 7 years was in the sack with another guy.
Yeah, this like smiley
tattoo thing on his
Well, kinda...
Okay, sir. Listen. We gonna take a break right now. Okay. We'll be back in a few moments. Thanks for calling.
Ah, yes, because when I think suicide attempt, I also think wacky music.
Another prediction. Someone will walk in and think that he's masturbating.
I don't want to talk, I just came to pick up my...
Wow, guess you were right again.
No, I wasn't.
What do you mean? Somebody walked in.
Yes, but this kind of gag usually involves a relative, or a nun, or something like that. This is his wife! Why would she be shocked at seeing her own husband jerking off? Actually, she left him. She should expect him to find new ways to pleasure himself. Also, ex-wife or not, who makes this kind of visit at 2:30 in the morning? Also, it's established that the previous scene took place a day earlier. How was she able to move out completely?
Well, it is possible if you only pack the essentials.
The essentials? Look at this joint! It looks like a set where they would film a post-apocalyptic movie! And why does she get to keep more things than him? I mean, clearly time works differently in this fictional universe, so I assume that they also had their divorce trial during this 24-hour window. Would a judge let a wife get away with this after she was caught cheating on her husband?
Mr. Kent.
Yes. Yeah, I just got a letter from the FCC. And if Leon Phelps is responsible for even one more tiny little fine, I get to fire him.
But before I go, I'd like to leave you with just one more thought. What is love?
What is this longing in our hearts for togetherness? Is it not the sweetest flower? Does not this flower of love have the fragrant aroma of fine, fine diamonds? Does not the wind love the dirt? Is not love not unlike the unlikely knot it is unlikened to? Are you with someone tonight? Do not question your love. Take your lover by the hand. Release the power within yourself. You heard me, release the power. Tame the wild cosmos with a whisper. Conquer heaven with one intimate caress. That's right, don't be shy.
Whip out everything you got and do it in the butt.
Not even 20 minutes in and I'm already annoyed by his lisp.
I don't mind the lisp in general, but it definitely ruined this joke. The punchline of saying something nasty that ruins the mood only works if there's a mood in the first place. Here there wasn't any, because listening to that voice is not romantic, no matter the words.
Isn't that a little insensitive towards people with speech impediments?
Anyone who watches my videos know that I'm not against using politically incorrect humor, although that's not what I'm doing right now. What I'm saying can't be offensive because the speech impediment isn't involuntary. An actor is pretending to have a lisp in order to sound funny. So from that point of view, I think my criticism is valid.
Ass tattoo. Have you seen this ass? Welcome to the VSA. Victims of the smiling ass. We will have our revenge.
Dude, we can read, you don't have to say it out loud.
Leon and his producer Julie go to some job interviews, but each interviewer reacts negatively when listening to a recording of the Ladies' Man show. Julie destroys the tape, but not until after the third interview. Huh? Why not after the first one?
Also, this is 2000, why are they using tape? Weren't CDs a thing at this point?
Don't you worry, Julie, there's only one thing to do. I must go and have sex. And wait for something to randomly happen. It'll work out. You'll see. It will randomly work out!
You will smell!
There's the random occurrence.
Comedy 101. If a character is saying a speech about how they will solve a problem with inspiring music in the background, it has to be something serious. Then the scene will immediately cut to them doing something else. Or trying to do what they had planned, but failing at it. Here, Leon achieves exactly what he had planned. How is this supposed to be funny?
Let's see here. Gas bill. Houseboat bill. Electrical bill.
A ticket for throwing trash in the water.
Ooh. It's a lady. She did not find her name, so I guess she thought I knew who she was. Cuckoo, cuckoo.
I could still pull a favor. Hopefully, over at WAMS from Cyrus.
Cyrus Cunningham, your ex-fiance, the one that dumped you, the one with the 3-inch penis.
Oh.
Listen, baby, the answer to all of our troubles is in this rich lady's letter and her money.
Her money. Leon, yeah. This is a love letter, not a lottery ticket. Mm. This is a woman who cared for you, who you called by a special pet name, who you called
a sweet thing.
I'm sure you've noticed it already, but it must be pointed out. Leon is a jerk.
Well, that's what draws women towards him, right? They think he's naughty but smooth or whatever.
No, I don't mean that he's a charming asshole. I mean, maybe he thinks he is, but no, he's just unlikable. And dumb. His head is as hollow as a campaign ad during a presidential election.
Democrat or Republican?
Yes.
Leon Phelps, you miserable, fat-headed jackass.
Oh!
What?
You expect me to let you stick your tongue in my mouth after 2 years?
Yes, I do.
I meet you under the stands at a dog track. You sweet-talk me into leaving. Next thing you know, I'm busting slobs at you in the bathroom of a Chuck E. Cheese. You call me your sweet thing.
Wait a second. It says here that we did it in a laundromat.
What?
Yeah, didn't you send me this letter about getting together and sharing your money, love?
See, this is what I mean. Leon's brain can't process that she's not the woman he's looking for, despite all the evidence. And then he approaches another woman during her wedding!
But that's supposed to be the joke, right?
Yes, but even in a comedy, a character's stupidity needs to have at least some level of realism. Moving on. Julie introduces Leon to that Cyrus guy. There's tension, and they seem ready to fight. Instead, Leon challenges him to eat the disgusting food from the bar.
Pick the leg you want, pick the leg you got.
This ain't the way, fam. Oh, boy, look like a chitlin to me.
Quiet, fam.
Yeah. Thank you, hard boy. Where'd you find these?
Eat all you want, boys. Eat all you want.
Wow, not only does this gag go on for way too long, it's also, like, actively repulsive.
Oh, these are good.
These are new.
These are good.
The bad boy.
These are mine.
No way. No,
I'm doing this first. Come on, I'm doing this first. Back off of them. I'm doing this first.
I did it.
Yes, right, you should be. Right. Yeah. You just ate some human shit. Why would you bother human shit?
Actually, that's a good point. Well, movie, are you gonna give us the answer? Movie? Hello? Can you hear me?
There's no way that I was gonna let that dude disrespect my Julie twice.
Your Julie? So she's an object?
I don't think he means it like that. It's probably just supposed to be cute.
Look, it's only cute when couples do it. When friends do it, it comes off as possessive. When you stand up for someone, there's a fine line between doing it out of support and doing it because you don't think they're strong enough to fight their own battles. Let's go back to that Barney guy. He joined the group that he found online, led by a man named Lance.
From this moment on, I declare our supreme manliness! Yeah!
I feel like this is something really special. Something tells me this is truly grand.
What the hell? This is so random. And because I have a really weird sense of humor, I'm not gonna lie, I actually kind of found this funny.
Oh, don't worry, there's nothing weird about that. While I don't think the lyrics are hilarious, compared to everything else in the movie, this is Rachel Bloom levels of wit. By the way, the choreography is pretty good. I guess this is where all the budget went to.
The time has come to kill the ladies' man! The time has come to kill the ladies' man!
His name is Leon Phelps.
You thought I wrote this?
Sorry, Leon. I'm not really interested in settling down right now.
Let's have a quickie for old time's sake. Let's do it like we used to. Real nasty.
Listen, maybe it's not a good idea. We don't have the time to do this.
We'll do it real quick. Come on, baby.
Wait, if they used to have sex like this before, why is Leon horrified? How many stages did this script go through? Because this is the kind of mistake that you would usually find in a first draft.
I can't believe it's finally over.
All of my dreams are here at hand.
Okay, that suddenly just stopped being funny.
Well, as you said before, the musical number came out of nowhere. That's what made it amusing. Repeating it creates the exact opposite effect, because there's no surprise anymore.
This stinks! He's not here and this stinks, and we know why he's not here, because he's not... He's gone.
So...
Okay, I'll admit it, that was also kind of funny.
My life really sucks. I just can't live like this anymore, you know? I am so tired of being the ladies' man.
What the... That was your choice!
You know, you were never the ladies' man to me. You've always been just plain old Leon Phelps.
A girl like you, that's what I need. I don't need some crazy mystery lady. DeLune! Sweet thing is Honey DeLune!
I am rich! Look out, Chicago! The ladies' man is... Back!
Yeah! I apologize for calling Leon unlikable.
Wait, you mean he's not unlikable?
Oh no, he is. It's just that he doesn't deserve to be called anything. He deserves to be ignored and left to rot for the rest of his days. I mean, what the fuck is this?!
Yeah, I'm not really a fan of this trope either, where person A is in love with person B, and then person B is in love with person C, and person B can't read person A's signs until it's too late.
No! What you're describing would simply be cliché. What we're seeing here is taking it a step too far! I mean, take it! How does Leon not realize that Julie has feelings for him? And it gets worse!
Hey Julie, you made it just in time. I'm on my way to see the girl of my dream.
Okay, even if we're willing to accept that Leon somehow forgot about the keys, his best friend just punched him! Is he not going to ask the reason for that? So Leon goes to find Honey DeLune, but he doesn't go through with it once he realizes that he's in love with Julie. His enemies find him and they plan on cutting his balls off.
Get me the bolt cutters.
Insert Fiona Apple joke here.
Leon tries to reason with them and he ends up saying a full monologue about how they're to blame because they weren't good husbands. He also confesses his love for Julie and mentions his wrongdoings. She arrives at the right moment to hear it and they kiss again. Oh God, there's so much bullshit going on right now. I don't even know where to start. But I'll try my best. First of all, Leon only mentions some of his mistakes, and they're not even the most egregious ones. And he doesn't apologize to Julie, not directly. Why does she forgive him? Second, when there's infidelity, it is important to explore all of the party's mistakes that led to such betrayal. However, this is usually done immediately after the truth has been exposed. That way, the couple uses the information to save the relationship. It's not usually done after the breakup because then it becomes more about pointing fingers. And that's what happens here. Leon doesn't say that Barney, Lance, and the others are part of the problem. He says that they are the problem. I would tell the movie to go fuck itself, but I'm too broken to keep yelling.
No! No!
Man!
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 I'm sorry, that was way too dramatic. I'm actually with these guys. You're all right in my book.
Oh, Comedy 101. Wait, I already said that. Comedy 102, I guess. If your character looks like they're about to do something bad with serious music in the background and then they change their minds and they point out how overdramatic it all is, that's fine. But that punchline needs a big contrast with the setup, so the first part has to be played straight. Viewers needed to believe that Lance was really going to shoot, but we couldn't because it was all filmed and edited like a gag. Not to mention the funny positions in which he held the gun. Anyway, Leon gets a new job, he marries Julie, they have a child, and it all ends with a pretty lame freeze frame.
Well, at least the movie's mercifully short and only 80 minutes. Well, I guess I was right when I said that this would be a bad SNL movie.
No, you weren't.
Dude, why do you keep doing that? Do you just love contradicting me or something?
No, listen, it is bad, but not for the reasons I originally thought. Whenever a comedic short subject, a sketch, a commercial, etc., is adapted into a longer format, it usually results in a series of events that don't come together as a real story, with the same gags being repeated over and over again. That's not the case here. There's a wide variety of jokes, and the plot has a proper narrative structure. It just so happens that the jokes and the plot are terrible. In terms of characterization, it doesn't feel entirely faithful to the source material, which is weird since a lot of the people in front of and behind the camera also worked in SNL. You see, in the show, Leon would give out terrible advice to his callers. No matter what they would say to him, He never realized how unappealing he was to anyone who wasn't a skank. Stop typing your angry comments. That's how Leon referred to them, and I'm just quoting him. It was always like this since his creation in 1997 until his final appearance in 2000.
That's right. Yes, America, it is your responsibility to go out October 13th and see a movie, a very funny movie, a movie entertainment weekly called...
Yeah, come on, Tim. Is that the only reason you came back this week, is to plug your movie?
No, Tina, I didn't. Came to see my friends. I miss this place. I had a great time here. And I also would like to say that I'm one of the stars of the Michael Richards Show, premiering on NBC in 2 weeks.
Let this be a lesson. If you try to advertise two things at the same time, they will cancel each other out, resulting in not one, but two flops. Where was I? Oh, right. There was some retooling during the adaptation process. I guess the makers thought that this concept wouldn't work as a feature film without a protagonist we can root for. This incarnation of Leon is charming enough to have a lot of friends who treat him like family. He wins over Julie's parents the very first time he meets them, and he scores with different types of women. The movie acknowledges that Leon has imperfections, but some of them are used as a setup for a redemption arc that he honestly doesn't earn, and others are treated as harmless quirks. In fact, in order to make Leon look better, certain characters were written to be sticks in the mud who need to loosen up, or villains who have something personal against him.
It's a telegram from Jimmy Walker.
Dear Leon, stop. The 70s are over. Stop. Oops, I seem to be dropping all your mail. I guess I'm a clumsy mailman.
You're a bad mailman.
As if that wasn't enough, there still are plenty of scenes where people are put off by Leon's personality.
Yeah, you sound painfully shy. Listen, this is what you should do. Go to the bus station or to a bowling alley and hang out with no underpants. Trust me, it worked.
What?
Yeah, you'd be surprised at how many men would approach you. I know that I would.
And speaking of contradictions, Leon's brain is supposed to be the size of a termite, right? So how is he able to outwit Cyrus? That being said, I have to applaud Tim. At times I forgot that he was playing a complete tool because he manages to show a lot of charisma. So does Karen Parsons, and they both generate chemistry despite their romance being so horrendously written. All Billy Dee Williams was told to do was smile and be smooth, but hey, he's good at it. Will Ferrell surprisingly seems to be channeling Jim Carrey. The non-rubber-faced Jim Carrey, I mean. It's not a great performance or anything, but I appreciate how he went for something a tad more subtle, knowing that he would later choose to be loud as his shtick.
And when he does, we're gonna be there to nail him and cut his balls off!
His main shtick. John Carl, are there any actors that stood out for you?
Oh yeah, Lee Evans. God, throughout the whole movie I kept thinking, what the hell is up with his performance?
Anyway, I give it 2 stars out of 5.
And I give it 1 star. Well, that's it for now. Please subscribe and join my Patreon.
And on my channel, Crazy Stupid Media, we do a series called 2000s Movies and Beyond, where it's exactly what it sounds like. We do music video reactions and just sometimes random movie reviews that have no theme whatsoever. Be sure to check that out. I'll see you guys later.
Goodbye, John Carl. Thanks for coming.